cares, anxious, being anxious of something. Amen? So today I would like to share to you what I have experienced in my life. I believe everyone have experienced it. Maybe it's very even more delicate than what I mean about anxious that I have, or cares, or problems, or worries that I experienced in the past week. But God is trying to remind us daily that no matter what, no matter how we experience, or no matter how we will struggle or walk, any dusty road or any bako-bakong daan sa ating mga buhay, He wants us to be reminded that He is with us, and He will always, He should be always our peace.
Amen.
Amen po? Amen. So let us open our Bibles in Genesis 12, verse 3. Can you open your Bible, please? Last time, last 30 years ago, when the pastor would say, please open your Bible with me. I can hear it like the flipping of the papers, your pages and Bible. Ganon. Ngayon. Or whatever. Right? So, in a chaotic world that we live in, please allow me to use the chaos or chaotic world, because it's really chaotic, right? Don't ever go far or farther inside the four corners of our house. Right? Is it only me? I mean, is it only in our family that have that reality that we're still living in this earth? I believe every one of us. So in this verse, I will bless those who bless you, and I will curse him who curses you. And in you, all the families of the earth shall be blessed. Earth. Sorry for my accent again. Seriously, how I wish there are other pastor that is present today, but there's no Pastor Alex, there's no Pastor June, and there's no Pastor Noli, so I need to stand. For that, I didn't have the peace 2 days ago, the other night, honestly. Because I said, Lord, again, I have many things to do. Then yesterday, I was planning to pray, but I was there stuck in the work where we went yesterday in our workplace. Sabi ko, I need to be home by 5:30. How can I be home by 5:30? When up to 6:20 I was still there. So I went home trying to think that I can really have my time with my God. Sorry if I'm so possessive with my God. You can also say that with my God. Because He's really my God in everything. So when I went home, this and that, and then I went up, I forgot that my body is so tired. And I fall asleep. I was preparing my bag, the other things, and my laptop. And I ended up sleeping. Sleeping, but I have that message already in my heart that I want to share with you all today. And even before yesterday or the other day, that verse and the verses that we are going to read today is really in my heart for the past 4 weeks. So bakit napakalayo ng ating binasa na verse? I will bless those who bless you, and I will curse him who curses you. And in you, all the families of the earth shall be blessed. In you, all the families It's a matter of putting ourselves in the position that wherever we are, let us continue to pray. Or pray means putting ourselves in the position that God wants us to do. Pray means like advocating, or other meaning of pray means asking, right? Pleading. Asking something, favor from God. This is in the sense of the Israelite people way back in the Old Testament, that God said, I will bless them, those who bless you, and I will curse them, those who curses you. For us Christians, we didn't realize that wherever we are, God put us, wherever God put us, whether sa trabaho, whether sa school as a kid, or a young people, young person, or sa family na, ang family mo, they're not Christians yet. Wherever God put us, we are like a powerful time bomb, ready to explode. Napakalayo naman ng peace, tapos binanggit mo yung time bomb. Now what I'm trying to say is, time bomb means our lives is really ticking. Tick-tock, tick-tock. We should always put in our hearts, and we should always be reminded that our lives, wherever God put us, there is always a reason. And that kind of reality or reality nga ba? Nagkahalo po kasi ang Bisaya, Tagalog, at English na nasa isip ko. The fact that the truth is, whenever we have God in our hearts, and the moment we accepted the Lord in our hearts, do you know that we can no longer touch the unclean? Extreme ka naman, Sister God. But seriously, yes. Because God said, you are a new creation. You are mine. I have bought you with my blood. I have died for you. But seriously, did we come to the reality that we have that mentality and the conscience that, yes, God, you are looking at me? No, right? Akala kasi natin, accepting God is a way of escape road. Ginawa natin escape road o escape highway si God, si Lord, when we accepted Him. Oh, I know that when I am going to accept the Lord, I will be blessed. Because He said, I will bless you more than what you can imagine or think. But seriously, there's more than that. Our responsibility is, He wants us to be His extension. He wants us to be His channel. He wants us to be His connection to those who are in need, to those who doesn't have peace. So therefore, because when God said to the Israelite people, because they are really chosen, because when we accepted the Lord God in our hearts, He has called us, but He didn't just call us up. He chose us. He has chosen us to serve Him. To serve Him? To stand here? No. To serve Him, to speak of the truth that in God, in Jesus, there is liberty. That in Jesus, there is peace. That in Jesus Christ, there is freedom. Freedom from what? From the genetic curses that our forefathers have committed. From the sins of our forefathers. From the curses of the law. From all the wiles and the plans and the lies of the enemy. That's why John 10:10 said, the thief cometh not but for to steal, to kill, and to destroy. I'm so angry with the enemy that up to now, we are so blinded. Everyone is already, we're professing we're a Christian. But how we live? is really guilty about that. My car, when I was driving right now, I didn't realize 15% oil life. Lord, what will I do? Do I need to go to the change oil, or it's already 10, Lord? If I go there, I'll be late. See? Our mind is the battleground. And there's always a war sa ating mga buhay. There's always war between the good and the bad. There's always war choosing to believe God, trust God, or no. Trust Him of who He is so that we will have peace in our lives. Pray for the peace of Jerusalem. Pray for the peace in our family. Pray for the peace in our workplaces. Pray for the peace above all of our heart. Pray for the peace that our hearts must have. Because above all, our hearts are deceitful. Our hearts is the number one enemy. Our emotions, ourselves is our number one enemy. It's not the devil. Mind you. Believe me. Because God said, I have bought you with a price. There is therefore now no condemnation for you who received me, who accepted me, who followed me. And then here comes the enemy. Okay, putting all the negative things in our mind, right? But as God daily encouraged us by His words, He said, no, Anna, you are really my child. There is therefore now no condemnation. But Lord, I'm so weak. Your mind, your own thinking, your own conscience would say, no. See, you fall again. See, you commit this sin again. See, you lied. Last Wednesday, I was asking God, Lord, am I lying? Did I lie just 2 minutes ago? Because there was a circumstance that I was telling one of in kausap ko, and I said, like suddenly the enemy said, you were lying. When I was really telling black and white, and the enemy said, you said the great part. See how the enemy can steal our joy if we don't have peace. Psalm 122 verses 6 to 7. May they prosper. Verses 6 to 7. It's Psalm 122. Anyway, Psalm 122, verses 6 to 7, it says, may they prosper, will live. Patricia, can you please read it? Okay. Pray for the peace of Jerusalem, may they prosper and who love you. That was a bad sentence. May they prosper who love you. And then verse 7. Peace be within your walls, prosperity within your palaces. Okay. We can always change Jerusalem word into our name. Pray for the peace of Connie. Pray for the peace of Chua family. Pray for the peace of for the world. Pray for the peace of United States of America. Pray for the peace of, for example, trabaho. Saan po kayo nagtatrabaho? Kaiser. Hindi ko pinopromote ang Kaiser. Pray for the peace of Jerusalem. And verse 7, peace be within your walls, prosperity within your palaces. Because when we pray for others, we will reap what we have sown. then God will give us peace and it will protect our lives. It is like our wall. It symbolizes not like a yung tubig sa puso, kapag naglalagay ka ng tubig, hindi ito maintindihan ng mga kabataan dahil hindi sila nakikon. But when we put water in the puso negro, right? And then it will come out like a lot of water because you put something on it, right? So it's the same with our lives. If we pray for the peace of someone's life, of whatever, then God will grant us peace. And it will protect us as hedges of protection towards our family, towards our businesses, towards our relationship, towards our workplace, towards our bank account. Bakit kaya may bank account pa? Pwede na may tago yung pera sa larin ng kama. I try to do that, but I always forget that I have money, and then when I don't have money, but wala yung pera ko, saan kaya napunta? And then, you know, don't worry, it's not 100 bills. They're like just $5, $1. So, pray for the peace of Jerusalem. Because once we pray for Jerusalem, it's so significant if we pray for Jerusalem. Because God said, because they're our chosen people, right? So if we pray for them, God will bless us. The same way if people pray for us, do you know that they will be blessed? If they serve us, do you know that they will be blessed? Because we have Jesus in us. The moment that God chose Jerusalem, the people, the Jewish people, it is in his heart, they are so precious in his heart, that all the coverings, all the protection, even how small he is, it's like some dot, you know? And then there's a lot of neighboring Arab countries, but he is so protected. Why? It is not the walls of Jerusalem that protects them. It is the hands of God that protects them. The same with us. Even how tall our bakod, so that no magnanakaw will go over our fence. But if really they have all the things, the technologies, they still can go inside. If the hands of God are not with us, right? Even how low is your bakod, even like our bahay namin, it's always nakakalimutan isarado ng mga anak ko pag lumalabas. When I come home, you know, it's not locked. I believe it is because of the hands of God. Amen? Amen? Amen. Amen? So pray for the peace of Jerusalem. Why I'm campaigning? Because we are dying times. Pray for the peace of your loved ones. If he or she is so anxious, pray without ceasing. 1 Thessalonians 5. Pray without ceasing means, even nagda-drive ka, even nagtatrabaho ka na sa computer, and then suddenly, God put something in your heart. Pray. Prayer is not long. Or it should not be long. Pray. As long as you have the desire to pray, to ask God, or plead God for your brother or for your sister, God is healing. God is considering to answer. Pray for the peace of Jerusalem. Pray for the peace of your husband. If he is worried enough, because the dollar sign in your bank is depleting. Because seriously, if you don't have a dollar sign enough. But it's been 4 years that I have the peace of God that passes all understanding. And sorry, again, I will say that even right now, I'm really ready. Not because I'm rich, but because I know my God will take care of everything. because He is taking care of everything for us right now. Do you think I have a lot? No. But every of what I only have, what we have, if we share them, it will return to us more than enough, succinctly, glig at umaapaw. Right? Do you think when you pray, God is not counting it? Do you think when we pray for others, God is not putting the one stroke? Every time we pray, there is a counting table or a stroke. Ang nagiging five, ang ginagano na niya, di ba? And because of that, there are blessings in our lives that we don't expect. Have you experienced those? When you were driving, suddenly there was someone trying to, you know, cut you up. And then there was a big truck in here. Or in here. God was there, He said, just stay in your line. Don't swerve. You will not be in an accident. Do you think it's your alertness? No. Do you think it is our reflexes? Good reflexes? No. It is God's divine hands that grant us the covering, and for that we should have that peace that passes all understanding. Amen?
Amen.
And the second one is why we should have to pray. There are three things that I want to discuss. And why, how do we do that? We should lift up. Because as we always say that we cannot minister if we are not overflow, right? We can only minister from our overflow. Sorry, my mind is so packed and my mouth is so lazy to talk, to speak up. Para akong naano. It is like we have that overflow deep within us, from our belly. And before that, we can minister. We should minister ourselves daily, asking God, reading His words, allowing Him to work within us, allowing Him to teach us, allowing Him to chop any unpolished part in our lives, right? What are those unpolished parts in our lives? There are a lot of things, and you're the only one who knows those. As for me also, I know what are the unpolished part of my life. The unpolished part of my life is I give easily. Is that lack of wisdom? Maybe for others, yes. But for me, it's not. As long as God is the one telling me, I don't care. So, we should lift up. Number one, lift up. Number two, intercede. Number three, ask God. So, lift up where? Where should we lift up our eyes to? To God. Whom we should lift up to? In the Jesus. In our family, whom? Whom we should lift up to our respect? To the Father, to Papa, to Daddy, to Tatay, to Ama, to Aba. If we don't have Papa already, to who? Mama? If we don't have Mama anymore, who? Kuya, Ate. These are the basic things in life that we don't realize. That if we put our respect and lift up our eyes, our respect, our not adoration, our trust, because we're still on earth, above all, we should lift up our eyes unto the hills from whence our help comes from. That is Psalm 121, verses 1. Our help comes from the Lord who made the heaven and the earth. Right? Oh my God, I don't think I will be married at the age of 30. I heard that from someone. Because she said, I need to do this, I need to do that. And so I told her, you know what? Just trust God and lift up your eyes to God and work. Work on what you have in your heart. And I'm so blessed when she shared that to me. Who am I for her to share that? But even though, out of her lips that comes out from that, she just shared to me, and I was so glad and so happy that I said, people are trusting you for their very desires. How much more if God hears us, not just asking, but telling him, like randomly telling him, right? Lord, I want this. Not just like because we are demanding in the Bible, but like, Lord, is it okay to have this? Because if we forget that there is someone higher than us, there is someone higher than the economy of the United States or the world, there is someone, the highest agency is in Philippians 4:19, the bank in heaven. It's not bankrupt, it's not going to be bankrupt. And it didn't suffer any depression, any recession, or any lack of funds, right? Lack of air to breathe the other day. That Lolo, that Tito, I didn't just show how my heart was like crushed. When he said, there's no one to take care of him, he's alone. And he was in a wheelchair. How I wish I could be the father. Like the Superman, that I can create things for him. But I'm not. But what I did, I said, Tito, don't worry po, at least, meron po kayong wheelchair na pwede niyong itulang at makapunta kayo sa gusto niyong puntahan. But what he meant was that he's alone, right? It's because he has that emptiness, it's because I believe he doesn't have Christ. But for us, it's a shame for us when, in fact, we know that God is for us. And if God is for us, who can be against us? At nagugulumihan at kaagad tayo. Nagpapanik kaagad tayo. Whom we should lift up our eyes to? To whom should we put our trust? It's not our company. It's not the boss that we see every day. It's not them. They are just the instruments. They are just the funnel, canal. They are just the link for the money to be put in our account. But seriously, if God would say, and let the employer's heart be hardened, he will fire you, he will fire us out like from nowhere, right? Then our resources, then we should know that our resources are not really from them. It's from God. So we should lift up our eyes to the hills that made heaven and earth.